Hi, and welcome to Questacon Science Time. I'm Dion.
And hi, I'm BJ.
We're talking about flight today. Come and join us.
Let's go.
Wake up, sun and moon. It's science time. It's science time. Wake up, skeleton. It's science time. It's science time. At home, in the bathroom, when we're swimming, there is science. Outside, at the playground, in the sunshine, there is science. Wake up.
So, does anyone know, if you look around the room, what do you think we might be talking about today? Does anyone have any ideas? What do you think? Well done. What do you think we might be talking about today? All the things around the room, you're flying. Well done. So we're going to be talking about flight today. Now, what sort of things fly? Do you know any things that fly?
Airplanes fly.
Airplanes fly. Well done. So what have we got a picture of an airplane here. Have you ever flown on an airplane? Hands up, who's flown on an airplane before? Has anyone been on an airplane?
Yeah.
Have you been in an airplane? It's a lot of fun. Yeah, and are they slow or fast, do you think? They're pretty fast, aren't they? They're very fast.
They go
poof when they take off, don't they? So what other things fly in the sky?
Like helicopters.
Well done, helicopters do. And they have something that goes around their head. They go waka, 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 waka. Can you see these things? So what are these things called? Does anyone know on the helicopter? Yeah, they make that sound, don't they? But they're called propellers. Can you say propeller? Propeller. So these are propellers and they help the helicopter fly. Yeah, they make a big noise, don't they? They can be quite loud, actually. So what other things?
They go like...
They do... They make a big noise. So what other things do you think can fly in the sky? What other things fly in the sky?
Airplanes.
Jets as well, yes? How about... How about this one here? We'll use this one here. What is this? Does anyone know? An air balloon, a hot air balloon. Now, did anyone go and see the hot air balloons? Yeah? Did you go and see hot air balloons? Have you ever seen a hot air balloon?
I haven't.
They're lots of fun. And where do hot air balloons go? Do they go down or up, do you think? They go up, don't they? They go up, they fly. Now, another thing that might fly goes into space and looks a little bit like this. So what would you call that, do you think? Ooh, close.
What do you use to fly in if you want to go into space?
What do you use to fly into space, do you think? What do you think?
A gun.
One of these ones. What do you think this is called?
The gun.
It's called a rocket ship. It's called a rocket ship. Have you ever seen a rocket ship before? Because this is one that goes into space. So that's how we get to space. We use a rocket ship by flying in a rocket ship.
And that's the fire.
It is. There's fire down here to help us fly. Now, these are some things that we make to help us fly, but are there any things that live and fly? Maybe things that do this?
What do you think? Animals can fly.
Birds, well done, yes, birds. So we have a bird here, which is flying. And what does it use to fly, do you think?
Wings.
What do you think?
Wings.
Yes, it uses wings, doesn't it? It uses wings to fly, very well done. And there are some other animals that fly as well. Maybe one that goes
bzzz. Bee.
It's a bee, well done. So there we are, we have our bee, and he's got some wings, and our bees are really, really good at flying. There we are, and they make that bzzz sound.
And they're red in flowers.
Yes, they can go in flowers, and they eat nectar and that sort of stuff. Now, another thing, there's also a really pretty thing that flies as well that you might have found in your garden before.
Butterfly.
Well done.
Oh, yes.
A butterfly, there we are. Now, hands up, who has butterflies at home? Has anyone got butterflies at home?
Yeah, we do.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you have butterflies at home? They're a lot of fun to look at, and they're really, really pretty, aren't they?
And also, you need to catch them.
You do, don't you? You need to catch them sometimes with a net or something like that. But you'll be very, very careful, because they can be very delicate.
I don't have bees at home.
You don't have bees at home? It's pretty lucky.
I have bees outside.
Ah, outside. That makes sense. So you've got bees in your garden, which makes sense. There we are. So we have lots of different things that fly, don't we? Lots of different things. Bats do fly. Well done. Bats fly as well. We've got another picture of a bat as well. When do bats fly? Do they fly during the day or at night time, do you think?
They fly at night time.
Well done. They fly at night time. So that's when bats fly. And they've got very, very good wings to fly with. So we've got some other things that are flying now.
But.
We're going to have a look at this now. What do you think this is? Does anyone know?
A balloon.
It's a balloon, isn't it? What do we need to put in our balloon to make it fly? We'll try it. We'll try it first of all. Do you think this balloon will fly if I let go of it?
Yeah.
Well, we'll have a go. You ready? 3, 2, 1. Oh, it didn't fly, did it?
No, we had to blow it up.
Ah, so what do we have to put inside the balloon to make it fly? We do, don't we? We have to put air inside. So what we're going to do, we'll get an air pump, which pumps some air, so you can feel the air pumping. Can you feel the air? Can you feel the air pumping? There we are. Can you feel the air? Can you feel the air as well? So we've got lots and lots of air pumping from our air pump, and we're going to put all of that air inside our balloon.
We can see the air.
You can see it on my hair.
Leon's hair. Thank you.
So we're going to use that air, and we're going to put it inside our balloon, and we're going to see if we can make this balloon fly. So we're going to put lots and lots of air inside our balloon. There we are, pumping, pumping, pumping. And what happens if I let go of this balloon, do you think?
Fly.
Where will it go?
Yeah.
Yes, it'll fly, won't it? So ready? We'll count down from three. Can you all count down with me? Three, two, one, blast off! Wow. Now, did that go very far?
Yeah.
Oh, a little bit maybe. Did it go very high?
No.
Not really, did it? Well, we're going to try a different balloon now, one that'll go higher and further. Now this is called a rocket balloon, which is a lot of fun to play with. It's a lot longer than the other one. And we're gonna try and put some air inside this rocket balloon now and see what happens. So we'll pump some air inside. And you can see as we pump the air, the balloon gets bigger and bigger. And the air means that hopefully we can make it fly. There we are. Now because it's a rocket balloon, we do need to count down as well. So we all ready to count down together? Three, two, one, blast off! Wow!
Whoa.
Well done.
Let's
now,
do that one more
we
time.
Might do that one more time. Did that go far? Did that go far away? Went pretty far away, didn't it? Did it go high?
Yeah.
It did go high, didn't it? So we're going to do it in a... Oh, well, we'll do that one a little bit later, but we'll try this one first, if I can get this one in. So we're going to pump up this balloon now. Put lots of air inside of it. You can see it's getting bigger and bigger. There we are. And we're going to launch our rocket balloon. There we are. So I need everyone to help me count down because it's a rocket balloon. We need to count down for it. Ready? Three, two, one, blast off! Wow! That was a bit of a noisy one, wasn't it? So we have lots of things to talk about in science today and lots of things to play with as well. So ready, set, go. Find your grown-up and explore the room. Let's go play. Have fun. Enjoy yourselves.
Having lots of fun, there's something really special I want to show you. Come with me. Hi there, boys and girls. Here I am at the Canberra Festival Balloon Spectacular. And today we're going up with our friends from Balloon Aloft in a hot air balloon. I think Dion's going to want to join us for this one. Dion!
Hi, boys and girls. This is a really big balloon.
We're inside the Questacon hot air balloon. And they're filling it up with hot air right now. Can you see? Now, hot air balloons fly really well because the hot air expands. So the hot air inside the balloon, there's less air inside than cold air outside. And that's what makes the balloon fly up in the sky. Now, Dion, it's time for you and I to get in the basket. We're going to go flying up in the sky. I wonder what we'll see. We might even see Questacon. You come with us. Let's go.
They're putting some more hot air into the balloon to fill it up with lots of hot air. Here we are, taking off. Up, up and away. Hold on tight, Dion. We're flying over Questacon. Look. Questacon! Look, there's Lake Burley Griffin. There's lots of other balloons flying up here with us today. It's so quiet and peaceful flying up here in the sky. They're using the burners again to keep the air nice and hot. Now it's time to find somewhere to land.
Wow! Now we're back on the ground.
That was so much fun.
That was so cool. Did you see us up in the sky? Oh, flying in the big Questacon hot air balloon. We could see Questacon from up there, couldn't we?
And we could see the whole of Canberra.
Oh, it was great. So thanks again for our friends at Balloon Aloft for taking us up in their big hot air balloon. And look what they gave us. Certificates. We're official. So let's head back to Science Time now and check out what everyone's up to.
Okay, so we did really, really exciting things in Science Time today, but we have a bit of an exciting demonstration now for you, or a bit of an experiment. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually take this big balloon here. We're going to have a look at this big balloon. There we are. Now this big balloon, if I drop it, do you think it's going to fly? Well, we'll test it. Ready? We'll all count down together. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Oh, didn't fly at all, did it? It didn't fly at all. So what we need to do is we need to make this hot air balloon fly. So this is a toy hot air balloon. How do you think we're going to make this hot air balloon fly? What are we going to put inside? Well, take the sticker off. That's a good thought. But what we've actually got a hole in the bottom here. What should we put inside our hot air balloon to make it fly, do you think? Yes, air. Well done. What do you think? What sort of type of air?
Sticky tape.
Hot air. Hot air is the one. Well done. You knew that, didn't you? We got some hot air. So what we're going to do is we're going to get our hair dryer, which you might have one of these at home, and we're going to make some hot air and see what happens to our balloon.
So this hair dryer has lots of air. You can feel the air. Can you feel that?
Oh, can you see the air?
Yeah.
Lots of hot air coming out.
So nice and hot. We're going to fill up. Oh, come here, balloon.
There we are.
We're going to fill up our hot air balloon with lots of hot air.
So all the hot air inside, when it gets hotter, it actually starts to get bigger, starts to expand. And that means that there's less air inside the balloon than there is outside the balloon. Now, can you see it filling up? Is our balloon almost full? It's looking pretty full, isn't it? It is what they do with a real hot air balloon. So, we've got to make sure that it's nice and hot inside in order for the hot air balloon to work. And I think we're going to let go of it very, very soon. So what we need to do is we need to do another countdown. Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Wow.
And look, our hot air balloon flew to the ceiling. It floated up, didn't it? Now, this hot air balloon, it's not going to be up there forever. Because what happens to hot things when they stand around, do you think?
The air comes down and falls.
Well done, it gets cold, doesn't it? It gets cold and it starts to get cooler and maybe start to fall down. So what's happening here is our balloon is starting to cool down and it's starting to float down now. Do you want to come sit on your bottom? Good work. Are you going to help catch, are you? There we are. Well done. So as the air gets cooler, it starts to float down and that's why we can reach it again, which is pretty cool stuff. And that's how a big hot air balloon works as well. They fill the balloons with hot air, makes it float up into the sky. So we have some things for you to take home today. And kids at home, you can have a look at these ones on the internet. The first thing is a parent information sheet. So here, sitting on your bottom for us, good work. We've got a parent information sheet, which you can get off the website. Really, really great thing to show you what to do at home and some extra activities. And we also have a colouring in for the kids as well. So what we're going to do, before we give you all these, we're going to say goodbye to all the boys and girls at home. So everyone look at the camera and say...
Can you look at the boys and girls at home?
And can we all say goodbye?
Bye. See you next Science Time. Bye.
And everyone, do you want to come and get yourself a colouring in?
Questacon Science Time is held at Questacon in Canberra, Tuesday to Friday during school terms. Bookings are essential. For further information, go to our website at questacon.edu.au. See you next Science Time.